Let's just say you've produced two types of hare's ear dubbing, the lighter, softer body fur on the left, and the slightly darker thorax fur on the right, that includes stiff guard hairs from the ears. You can store these different dubbings in small plastic bags if you like, but I've found dedicated dubbing containers to be much more functional. Here, you can really see the color difference between the two blends. Once you've pulled the dubbing up through the little holes, you can pluck the material free using just one hand. With the body material, I like to create a simple dubbing noodle on my tying thread, then make touching wraps with it to form the body of the fly. This I'll often rib or segment with wire or tinsel. For the coarser thorax material, I greatly prefer a split thread dubbing technique to make those coarse guard hairs stand out. It may be a little more work than a normal noodle, but the results look really good, with the longer guard hairs mimicking legs and the softer fur producing the illusion of movement.